Hey, it's Raj from 3CB Performance. Current Juventus superstar and footballing legend Cristiano Ronaldo was once a feared frick-a-taker, netting 44 goals over his first 12 seasons. I detailed his techniques in my last football video. However, his success on free kicks has taken a severe hit in recent years, having scored no free kick goals for Juventus in non-exhibition games. He had a very fortunate ricochet goal in a 2019 ICC versus Inter, and overall, only 9 free kick goals on 174 attempts since 2014. A paltry 5% success rate, the worst of any player to have scored 5 free kicks during that time period. In this video, I'll analyze potential reasons for his recent struggles and possible solutions. Cristiano's knuckleball technique is a delicate balance of power, lift, and striking the ball without creating spin. When looking over his free kick misses since 2014, the power is still there, but he's struggling to get lift on the ball or generate the unpredictable movement that characterizes a well-hit knuckleball. That begs the question, what has changed? We'll likely never know the true root causes for Cristiano's free kick woes, but we can take some educated guesses based on known variables. Comparing Cristiano's free kick technique pre-2014 to 2014 and beyond, there's no discernible differences on tape. It's the same distinctive routine with a step back, V-leg position, deep breaths, and pulling up on the shorts. Run up with a vault step and left leg planted closely to the ball and instep strike. For much more detail on the technique, I encourage you to watch the video I made specifically on his technique. The major caveat here is that there very well could be indiscernible differences that aren't apparent on film study. For example, the velocity of his swing leg, trunk ankle, specific contact point, ball spin rate, etc. Even if these differences are only very minor, they can cascade, especially if early on in the movement, and affect the very sensitive free kick movement sequence. It's like doing a multi-step math problem where the earlier you round an answer, the more error you have at the end. I've heard and read many people partly attribute Cristiano's struggles to changes in the ball itself, but that argument doesn't add up when looked into. Although the research certainly indicates different ball characteristics can influence ball movement in the air, for example, the 2010 World Cup ball Jabulani created all sorts of zigzag movement. Cristiano played with multiple different ball iterations prior to 2014, Nike iterations in the Premier League and La Liga, and Adidas iterations in the Champions League, yet seemingly had no issue. He has continued to play with Nike and Adidas iterations since 2014, including during his time at Juventus. The ball change argument implies there was some fundamental change made to both the Nike and Adidas balls in 2014, and these changes were carried over to every iteration thereafter. Not only does this sound like an extremely unlikely coincidence, more importantly, there's no evidence to support that assertion. When reviewing Cristiano's injury history, there's an uptick in lower body muscular injuries that aligns with his free kick decline in the 2013-14 season and onwards, following 2 years of excellent health in the 2 seasons prior. However, typically when injuries interact with the performance, you see a player decline in multiple areas, which hasn't been the case for Cristiano. Taking both sides into consideration, I believe it's reasonable to think injuries may have played a role in the decline, especially early on, and then with subsequent misses, snowballed to affect Cristiano's confidence. Confidence and rhythm are critical aspects for free kicks, in which success or failure depends on very thin margins, with a knuckleball technique having even thinner margins. Movement research clearly indicates that rhythm and confidence optimize movement patterns, termed, quote, neuromuscular priming, and it's why free kick routines are so important. When confidence decreases and rhythm is disrupted, players tend to start overthinking their movements and have increased feelings of pressure and anxiety. These are termed, quote, internal distractions. Considering Cristiano's free kick record over the past 6 years, it's quite plausible he falls into this category, and his frustration after failed attempts has become increasingly evident. The research further tells us these internal distractions would significantly impact a player like Cristiano, who is considered to be in the expert automatic phase of the free kick movement and had considerable success in the past. A pre-strike routine can also become a double-edged sword when things start to go south, with the mind and body associating that routine with negative outcomes and reinforcing anxieties. Therefore, it could benefit Cristiano to break out of that vicious cycle by changing his routine. A great case study on the power of changing a routine is NBA player DeAndre Jordan of the Brooklyn Nets. Prior to the 2018-19 season, he was essentially the worst free throw shooter in the league's history, hitting only 45.5%. The league average hovers around 75%. Jordan admitted that his problems were more mental than anything else. He then made minor changes in his free throw routine, immediately grabbing the basketball after being fouled, rather than walking away from the free throw line, asking a player around him a random question like, "Hey, who are you defending?" immediately prior to the free throw, rather than staring at the rim. Staggering his foot position to feel more comfortable. Following these changes, he raised his average to 71% and 68% over the past 2 seasons. For more details, read excellent NBA writer Kevin O'Connor's piece on The Ringer. Cristiano may benefit from adopting a more conventional technique that has a higher margin of error, like his instep side spin technique that he's shown to be quite comfortable with, but only uses infrequently. To that point, he felt comfortable enough to use and execute it in a high-pressure situation on a late game-tying goal versus Spain in 2018. This switch could allow Cristiano to focus on one technique and perfect it. Like Lionel Messi has done in recent years and become an absolute beast. I made a video on his technique a few weeks ago. Cristiano taking a break from free kick duties could help him reset, regain confidence, and wash away the mental stains of the past 6 years, especially if that next chapter is reinforced by moving on to and optimizing a new technique. It's like a new beginning. I've personally seen this strategy work for high-level athletes across multiple sports, football, basketball, tennis, baseball, who had a previously successful approach turn into an extended rut that required a new perspective. The reality for Cristiano is that it's been 6 years of a negative trend line. Something isn't working and needs to change. If he still can't work out the issues, the worst-case scenario is that he permanently gives up free kick duties to Marilyn Pjanic and Paulo Dybala, allowing Cristiano to focus on what he still does extremely well, be a dynamic, game-changing force in open play. That's a wrap for this video. Thanks for watching. My goal is to provide you with in-depth, evidence-based, narrative-free analysis. You can always find me on IG and Twitter at 3CBPerformance. Please take care of yourselves and follow the appropriate precautions to limit your exposure to and spread of COVID-19. Make sure to subscribe to the channel and follow along on all social media for the latest updates. 3CB out.